Namah Shivaya students, hope you are all doing well. Today we are going to do the question answers from the topic A New Flower. You will write it down in your English literature classwork copy. Okay, so first you write the heading of the chapter A New Flower, then write the questions. Okay, question number A, make sentences. Number one, hunt. Number two, delicate. Number three, blossom. Number four, cluster. Number five, prospect. You can make your own sentences. Then topic number B, answer these questions in a few lines. Question number one, describe the weather in the Himalayas on the first day of spring. Answer, a cold wind hummed and whistled through the pines while dark rain clouds were swept along by the west wind only to be thrust back by the east wind. Question number two, where was Usha coming from and what had she done to keep her hair from blowing? Usha was hurrying back from school. She had tied a scarf round her head to keep her hair from blowing. Then question number three, what did the flower that Usha showed to the writer look like? Answer, it was a single butter yellow blossom and it stood out like a bright star against the drab winter grass. Question number four, what are the various seasons described in the story? Write some of the words that are used to describe the seasons. Answer, the various seasons are summer and autumn, with their own more showy blooms, winter, with cold winds blowing from all directions. Then question number five, what did the writer find when he went to see the flower the day after it had rained? Answer, the writer found that the flower had disappeared in the storm, but two other birds, unnoticed by Usha and him the day before, had opened. It was as though two tiny stars had fallen to earth. Now, question number six. How did Usha drive the goats away? Answer, she unfurled her pretty blue umbrella and advanced on the goat, shouting at it in goat language. Then question number C, topic C, read the lines from the story and answer or reference to the context. Question number one, shall I pick it for you? Question number A, who said these words and to whom? Question number B, what does the word eat refer to? Question number C, what reply did the listener give? So you are going to start your reference to the context with this line. I hope you have all remembered. Question number A, answer. This line is taken from the prose A New Flower, written by Ruskin Bond. These words were said by Usha to the narrator. Question number B, answer. The word eat refers to a single butter yellow blossom, a flower growing on the hillside. Question number C, answer. The listener said not to pick it up to Usha as it may be the only one of its kind. Then question number 2. Start with quotation, may it multiply. Question number 2A, what does it refer to? Question number B, what does multiply mean here? Question number C, what were the adversities despite which it flourished? Answer A. This line is taken from the prose A New Flower, written by Ruskin Bond. The word eat refers to a single butter yellow colored flower. Question number B, answer. Here multiply means to increase greatly in number. Question number C, answer. The adversities for the flower were extreme nature and animals. Then think and answer, that is topic D. Question number one, what kind of a person do you think is the narrator? Write a character sketch in about 5 sentences. Answer, The narrator who is telling the story is a freelance writer. He is very fond of nature. He is also friendly and can easily become friends with a small school-going child. He likes flowers very much and doesn't want to harm them. The narrator, in true sense, is a nature lover but knows his limitations as a human being. Question number 2. What do you think the phrase "my dignity was saved" means? Same question. Why does the narrator think that his dignity was saved by Usha? Answer. The phrase "my dignity was saved" means that he did not have to run away from an angry looking goat in front of a small girl. The narrator thinks his dignity was saved by Usha because she used an umbrella to shoo away the goat and also spoke to it in goat language. Question number 3. Why did Usha and the writer forget about the flowers as the days became warmer? Answer. As the days became warmer, the flowers faded and finally disappeared. Both of them forgot due to their daily chores. Like Usha had her lessons and exams to worry about, while the narrator had other mundane worries like paying rent, electric bill, etc. Well, students, we come to the end of the chapter discussion and question answers of A New Flower. Next class, we will start with another chapter. Till then, students, Namah Shivaya.